On September 10th of 2023, something unusual occurred on a section of the Krysuvik Volcano in Iceland, as a section of ground at this very volcano adjacent to a Pleistocene-age spatter cone has mysteriously begun to greatly increase in temperature. This has occurred in two spots, with temperatures as warm as 54 degrees Celsius or 129.2 degrees Fahrenheit being measured. These warm patches did not exist at the end of August 2023, meaning they must have formed at some point in the last 2 weeks. The YouTube channel Just Icelandic, who you should definitely subscribe to by the way, and who took this footage, became curious when he spotted these fumaroles emitting a white plume of gas where there was previously nothing. As a regular to the area, Just Icelandic knows the region well, meaning he was not simply unaware of an already known feature. To prove this point, here is a brief video clip of the first of two relevant spots in 2022 with no fumaroles or visible degassing. And now, here is that same spot on September 10th of 2023. This sudden change in the Krysuvik volcano's geothermal features could theoretically be a potential cause for concern, as changes in geothermal features at a volcano can be a sign of changes occurring at depth or even possibly an intrusion of magma. However, the new fumaroles which popped up are not aligned with the overall volcanic complex. While Krysuvik consists of a series of fissures that have not erupted since the 14th century and has volcanic fissures which trend towards the northeast, the new fumaroles are not elongated along this orientation, instead pointing towards the east-southeast at an angle of 340 to 350 degrees. This could mean one of three things in my opinion, which I will list from most likely to least likely. The first and most likely explanation is that the sudden appearance of these new fumaroles does not imply anything truly suspicious, as at volcanoes around the world, some of which have not erupted for as many as 70,000 years, hot springs and fumaroles can regularly appear and disappear without an eruption ever occurring. This is what somewhat recently occurred at the Yellowstone volcano when a new geothermal area began expanding around 2001 as what was previously an area filled with trees began to die before becoming discolored, eventually being followed by the distinctive white color found at numerous geothermal features. Something similar occurred at the Lone Valley Caldera volcano in early June of 2023, where a new hot spring formed, while on May 11, 2023, a new hot spring formed on a section of the Hengo volcano in Iceland, right underneath the road, causing a section of pavement to melt. But, in all three cases, nothing suspicious was occurring at each volcano. Since the new fumaroles appeared only 100 to 200 meters north of a highly hydrothermally altered region that looks like it was once active at some point in the last several thousand years, these new features could merely be an extension of the same complex. Long-term increases in rainfall can trigger the formation of such features, and it might not be a coincidence that September is the second wettest month on the Reykjanes Peninsula. Possibility 2 is that these fumaroles already existed beforehand with no one noticing them, having likely been intermittent. After all, there are two cracks in the ground which might be related to these features right next to them, although they might simply be an unrelated fault rupture. The third and least likely possibility is that magma is actually moving underground beneath this location, probably at 12 kilometers depth in a horizontal manner. It might not be a coincidence that each of the three Fagradalsvik eruptions have occurred further northeast of the prior eruption. Thus, we could be seeing the early stages of an eventual future eruption, perhaps months to years from now, where the same body of magma is currently in the process of moving from Fagradalsvik to the Krysuvik volcano. This assertion is potentially supported by the fact that a series of earthquakes have occurred during the last 2 months between these two systems along a line that roughly parallels the orientation of the new fumaroles. Whichever of these possibilities is correct is unclear, as only time will tell. Thanks for watching, and a special thanks to Just Icelandic for permitting me to use his video footage. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.